यू नो एज ह्यूमन बींग्स वी फील कि ये व्हेन सम एबनॉर्मलिटी हैपेंस नो वी थिंक्स इट विल थिंग्स विल नेवर गेट बैक टू नॉर्मल.
एवरीथिंग केम टू अ स्क्रीचिंग हॉल्ट व्हेन कोरोना वायरस टुक द स्ट्रीट्स. दैट होल्ड्स ट्रू फॉर द एंटरटेनमेंट इंडस्ट्री एज वेल. देयर इज होप बिकॉज़ वी आर ओपनिंग अप एंड इन अ बिड टू शेयर द होप टुडे वी हैव राइटर डुओ सिद्धार्थ एंड गरिमा जॉइनिंग अस फॉर अ क्विक चैट. सिद्धार्थ एंड गरिमा वेलकम.
थैंक यू फॉर हैविंग अस.
थैंक यू. यू नो लेट्स डाइव राइट इन. Tell us, how has the lockdown life treated you? I mean, I'm assuming it mustn't have been easy.
We are mostly used to self-imposed lockdowns. So,
but when this happened, you know, it's like when you impose it on yourself and when it is like a thing when you cannot go out,
right.
It was very different after. For the first month, we thought, we didn't think we could sustain it.
You know, writing is often called an isolating experience. Tell us, has this lockdown been any kind of retreat or would it be wrong to call that? Or, you know, was a dearth of motivation.
You're absolutely right. I mean, you know, we were very used to going out of town and writing. In fact, for all our scripts, research has been a major thing. So we are very
correct.
Used to going to the station that we are writing for and, you know, writing in there. But being at home and writing like this, writing from one place is not something we were used to at all. What we've done is we've kind of disciplined, which we've always done. We've disciplined our writing hours. People would like to believe ki you can get ideas when you're thinking in a certain zone, sitting in a beautiful location, but not necessarily. Sometimes you
right.
have to just put your head down and crack something.
So was this the quiet time that you wanted or it was something far from it?
You have to give yourself a bigger challenge than what you're facing in life. Mm. So we thought, what bigger challenge than a blank page?
Of course.
Right.
You know, stare at a blank page, look at your laptop and think of the film that will eventually play in the theater.
Yeah.
That seems like a bigger, bigger task and bigger danger for us.
Correct.
So when you channelize, that's when you channelize yourself, ki bhai chhod dete hain, what is happening outside? Let's concentrate on this blank page for now. It's a misconception that, you know, you need to go to a picturesque location and, you know, and then that's when your thoughts flow and stuff. ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता यार. Actually, it flows from your mind.
Right.
If you think something, if you read a book, you get some, get inspired, and you maybe come up with a scene.
So, were you guys actually working on something during this time, or you know, was it difficult to come up with that? Because obviously, it's a trying time.
So we are very used to a lot of interacting with people. You know, in the sense that when you're writing something, there is a thing of narrating it to people. We've been doing Zoom narrations, you know, and stuff like that. But it's tough sometimes when you don't have any interaction and you're close, because we are very interactive in that sense. You know, we like to get that thought and we like to toss our thoughts across with people. So when that didn't happen, in a way, I would say that also worked for us.
Mm-hmm.
Because we were able to come up with things. We knew, okay, now these are the four walls where we have to sit and create. You know, so we were able to come up with stuff which we thought, chalo, ye try karte hain. A few new ideas in that process.
Yeah. So we managed to finish actually two hardbound scripts actually in
Amazing.
This lockdown, which is like a big deal.
You know, content creators, especially on the internet, they've actually gone ahead and laid down the basic essentials for a small gig at home, you know, like a one-man project. But as writers, what are the hurdles or what are the challenges, you know, that comes up when you're thinking about a do-at-home project?
Essentially, for a do-at-home project, of course, first of all, your location is very limited. You know it is going to happen with a very, very limited crew. So those are the things that you keep in mind and you write. You don't really say that a battle is used. You don't put too many characters in it.
Correct.
So, you know, once you know that these are your limitations, automatically things will fall in place. You'll write accordingly. Yes, it is a little limiting.
Yeah, like an open ground.
Or a, you know, like real locations and all that. One would really want to go out there and shoot. But then if in these 6 months, that is what is getting created and somebody comes to us with something like that, we would happily write something within the four walls, you know, keeping the restrictions.
So I feel it's a very temporary solution,
yeah.
But eventually people will have to go out. Yeah, cinema is for a bigger screen. So
of course.
But you know, even given the nature of digital, I mean, when you see something on the web, it is this much, right? You have that much scope to show. So whatever other shows you've been seeing, like what stuff that TVF has been creating, is short and very limited means. So that kind of stuff will sustain. I don't think this is such a big problem for them. But for cinema folks, I think it is limiting in a huge way.
So was it frustrating as a writer?
Yeah, what we generally write, it takes about a year to get made.
Right.
You know.
Right.
So we have to think that ahead of our this thing. Ek saal ke baad kaisa.
Right.
So luckily we have not created anything related to Corona. So it is not like
we'll have to be confined.
Yeah. So, हमारे लिए it's not been a challenge actually, if you ask us.
But that's the hope, right? I mean, we are opening up. Avatar has resumed the shooting, and eventually, that's the hope. I mean, you know, for everything to kind of fall into the bigger picture, because of course we have the streaming options, but theatricals are irreplaceable. Am I right?
Totally. Even in London, or for that matter, in India, Goa is open for shoots. Right. I mean, people who are directing things sitting here, you know, on a Zoom call in Goa, taking the actor UP from there. So those things are happening slowly. Okay. And it will be a matter of time before we know that we are back to into the groove. You know?
Yeah. Also, so, June 21st, the world was supposed to end, according to the rumors. So now that if we have survived that, we might as well survive this. No.
Yeah.
Yes. It is a little demotivating when you feel that whatever you were planning, like, for example, we had a film which is already on floors. So that has
got pushed
further, you know. So that, those are the things that bother me.
You know, I have to ask you this. So there have been reports where filmmakers have gone ahead and registered titles and, you know, ideas revolving around Corona. There was, I think, something called Corona Pyar Hai. What is your take? What is your whole take on that? I mean, are we just milking the cash cow? Is it too soon? What do you think?
You know, want to register Ye Sab Mat Corona.
Yes,
it's a phase that nobody would want to remember later.
See, we understand that this is an unprecedented situation and it has come upon the world like a never before thing, you know.
Absolutely.
But and I'm sure it's a hotbed of ideas. Many people are creating great stuff, and hats off to them for doing that. But we feel that in the larger picture, this is going to be one of those things that, okay, 2020 mein hua tha.
Yeah, but Bollywood is notorious like that, right? This is not something new to us. We've been doing this for a while now, actually.
Yeah. See, Anurag Kashyap has recently come up with a film on demonetization, you know, which happened like 4 years ago.
I'm
sure people will create stuff on it. And
even the Balakot thing that happened, you know, so many people went ahead and registered the title Balakot Fight, the Balakot battle. Right.
We feel there are issues that are larger and which are more long-sustaining, which need, if at all we want to do an issue-based film, which can have a whole film on them. And we have something like that we are working on. You know, so Corona is not really on our radar as of now.
You know, as human beings, we feel ki ye, when some abnormality happens, we think things will never get back to normal. That's human tendency.
Permanent to think like that.
Ki aray, aisa hi hoga, people will not, you try to judge it and you, then all that, you know, 2 months later, nobody will be discussing this probably.
Yeah. Ki, 2 months early, maybe six months later.
Now, I can't let you go without asking you this, and it's something I'm really keen on knowing. Do you think the audiences and their viewing patterns or the consuming habits will change, you know, post the pandemic, you know, when we come out of this, hopefully? Because obviously we are exposed to a plethora of content out there and quality content. So do you think, you know, makers have to up the game and, you know, step up a notch to stand out really?
The pandemic, no pandemic, it is always a challenge because you have to break what is already happening, you know.
Yeah.
And viewer is now open to all kinds of cinema from world over.
Right.
So that, you know, that wo jo hota tha hamare industry mein plagiarism hota tha, free makes, jinko kaha jata hai, ki they take the rights without and they change the world and just make
inspiration.
Ab thoda difficult hai because of the OTT coming in, stepping in, the game is.
Yeah.
But that's the evolvement of a natural process of evolvement, I think. For the audience also, they know that this was taken from there. This was in the notebook. Mein tha ye scene.
Right.
So that happens.
It's become very accessible, you know, those things. Mm. And pre-pandemic, we'd like to believe that, you know, there were different films that were working. And that is a beautiful thing, you know. People are not ready to take just anything. I mean,
absolutely.
Not name someone, but there are some big stars whose films are not working in the box office anymore.
Absolutely.
Because people are refusing to, you know, take that kind of content. And my take on the whole thing of whether digital is going to impact cinema. Right. So cinema is here to stay. Cinema has its own cinematic qualities. There are some things that people still love about going to a theater and watching a film, which OTT also is a very limited access. I mean, even now, it's not like we've penetrated the entire country. I mean, when you say satellite, yes, I mean, a larger number of people have access to TVs, but with internet and everything, we are still very limited.
Right.
So I think as filmmakers, all we need to do is just step up our game in terms of the kind of content we are providing to them.
Absolutely.
That's what
we would like to believe. You know, like people said, after TV came in, newspapers will be gone.
been so many people who want to rush to the theaters the day they open it. I mean, it's not like, I mean, I wouldn't dare step into a theater for the next, say, 3-4 months.
Yeah.
But there are people who are excited about it.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's a major thing with us.
Well, thank you so much for joining us and, you know, sharing insights. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.